I hang out with a pretty trashy circle, the circle that helps this circle. It starts when we recycle trash at home. It's completed when we buy products made from recycled materials. Check the label for something called post-consumer recycled content. Then buy the highest percentage of it you can find. Complete the circle.
Call 1-800-CALL-EDF for your free buy recycled shopping guide. 1-800-CALL-EDF.
It is a test, not just of strength, but of the power of the mind. And if you complete the journey, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
It's the end of the semester and finals are just around the corner. Plus, some SWT students begin a new Welcome Home program for seniors. I'm Shauna Ware.
And I'm Shelley Hallman. These stories and more on News 23 Wednesday.
This is News 23, a student production of SWT's Department of Mass Communication.
During finals, rush and anxiety are everywhere. Library hours are extended, students seek tutoring, and begin to sell their books. News 23's Margarita Lopez has more.
Starting next Monday, the library will open at 7:30 a.m. and close at 2 in the morning. Head circulation librarian Albert Chang says, since SWT is not a research library, it won't be open 24 hours a day during finals. Chang says only about 100 people per day take advantage of the extended library hours. While preparing for finals, some students seek help for various subjects in the Slack Lab. Unfortunately, the Slack Lab closes the last day of classes, but Slack has another option.
A student can call Slack and ask for a private tutor. And during this time, we will give them the name and number of persons who can help them if we have these people available.
While some students seek help and use a library to study, other students rely on superstitions.
About a week or so before finals, we start growing out our good luck beard, and you just don't shave until your last final is done. And even about a week after that last final, just to hold out through the grading process, just in case, you know, that might kind of grease the grades a little bit.
During finals week, students also have to worry about selling back books. The official buyback period began Monday, and some bookstores try to give students a fair deal.
I'd like most students to walk up here and walk away with somewhere in the neighborhood of $65 when it's all said and done. We do have a number of students that walk away with $125.
Despite library services and superstitions, the key to succeeding on finals may be as simple as getting a well-balanced meal and a good night's rest. For News 23, I'm Margarita Lopez.
Good news for financial aid recipients, no more waiting in long lines for checks. The financial aid office will now mail the checks to students. In past procedures, the students had to wait in long lines for hours to pick up the reimbursements. They were required to prove eligibility at the financial aid office, pay tuition at cashiers, and then return to financial aid with a receipt for reimbursement. Now the main requirement is that the recipient's local address is correct. If you have moved recently, your address can be updated through the CATS system. If not, you can relax. The first set of checks will be mailed out Friday.
A group of SWT students is showing more than respect for the elderly. News 23's Lizette Luna has the story.
Four SWT social work students are starting a welcome home program for new residents at the Arboretum of San Marcos Nursing Home.
Thank you. they want to get me, I'm gonna be ready to get them.
They just shoot. They don't care who gets in the way.
I want to be respected. Just gets me respect, know what I'm saying?
I'm afraid to walk to school, okay?
Yeah, I might die. Everybody dies.
Kids shooting, kids getting shot. They're all victims of gun violence. The killing won't stop unless you help stop it. Call 1-800-WE-PREVENT for free information. Not one more lost life. Not one more grieving family. Not one more.
I don't want to die.
Find out what financial problems the San Marcos School District is facing and a San Antonio bar fight turns fatal. Hi, I'm Nathan Carley.
And I'm Tasha Clark. All this and more today on News 23.
This is News 23, a student production of SWT's Department of Mass Communication.
High utility bills and rising health insurance costs are draining the financial reserves of the San Marcos School District, forcing officials to find ways to reduce spending. News 23's Jacqueline Kahn has the story.
The San Marcos Independent School District board members unanimously agreed to seek voter approval for a $93.5 million bond election on May 5th. If the bond passes, it would finance the construction of two new elementary schools, a middle school, a ninth grade center at the high school, and renovations to all existing campuses.
Right now, the district is not bankrupt. That can't happen here in the state of Texas, at least not while it's not going to happen. The district has a lower fund balance than I prefer, the district prefers.
The bond package accepted by the Citizens Facility Task Force calls for extensive renovations at the high school, including new air conditioning and heating, flooring, lighting, and electrical upgrades to enhance the learning environment.
It will get us some new facilities and some new updates for some of the existing, like for example here at Hernandez. It would help add additional restrooms. We do have 1,000-plus students, and so we need additional restrooms. It would upgrade our cafeteria and kitchen.
New construction includes a replacement school for Bowie Elementary, an additional elementary school, and a new middle school to relieve overcrowding in the district. Early voting is now available and will last until May 1st. You can vote at San Marcos CISD Administrative Office and at San Marcos City Hall. For News 23, I'm Jacqueline Kahn.
Over 30,000 deaths every year in the United States are the result of suicide. Among college-age students, suicide is the third leading cause of death. A new course at Southwest Texas State University called The Sociology of Suicide will analyze the risk levels for suicide among different age groups. The new upper-level sociology course will be offered starting in the fall 2001 semester. The class will be open to any students interested in taking it, and will be the only one of its kind offered in the country. Sociology 3321 will be offered from 11 to 11:50 a.m. on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays in Evans Liberal Arts Building, room 218.
Four Palestinians have been killed in the bomb blast at a school in the town of Rafah in southern Gaza. Gaza police say someone planted three bombs at the school yesterday, and although two of the bombs were defused, the third bomb did go off. At least three of the murdered victims were police officers, and four others were injured in the explosion.
Today marks the 15th anniversary of the Chernobyl nuclear disaster in the former Soviet Republic of the Ukraine. The 1986 explosion and fire was the world's worst civil nuclear accident. It sent radioactive clouds over much of the Ukraine, Russia, and Belarus, as well as other parts of Europe. Victims of the accident are demanding compensation for living on contaminated land. The Ukraine's government owes victims an estimated $136 million. Ukrainian officials say more than 3 million Ukrainians suffer from some form of radioactive contamination.
An 11-year-old Indiana boy who admitted shooting and killing his abusive father will not go to jail. Wayne Salyers Jr. pleaded guilty to voluntary manslaughter after being charged for the August 25th murder of his father. A judge sentenced Salyers to an indefinite sentence in a residential juvenile facility yesterday. The boy will remain under court supervision until he is 21. He said he thought killing his father was the only way he could escape the abuse.
It began as a bar fight and ended in death.
A 28-year-old man in San Antonio, Texas, died after being run over and dragged by a car for nearly 4 miles following a bar fight. Authorities charged 28-year-old Manuel Garcia in connection with the death of Enrique Ramirez, Jr. Witnesses say the bar brawl broke out early yesterday morning, and then Garcia ran down Ramirez in his car, dragging him for several miles. Following a blood trail, police found the 1988 Buick Century on the side of the road with Ramirez alive and face up underneath the car. The victim died hours later at a local hospital. The suspect, who faces murder charges, is behind bars on a $500,000 bond.
The trial of former Symbionese Liberation Army member Sarah Jane Olson is set to begin next week in California. In light of that, the FBI is turning to the last fugitive member of the SLA, James Kilgore. Yesterday in San Francisco, the FBI unveiled a bust of what the fugitive might look like today in hopes someone will spot Kilgore and turn him in.
IBM has taken to the streets of Chicago to promote its new Linux computer operating systems. A spokesperson for IBM confirmed the company has been painting peace symbols, hearts, and smiling penguins on sidewalks at various locations in the Windy City. The Linux logo is a smiling penguin, but not everyone's smiling. IBM's Peace, Love, and Linux campaign could result in fines of up to $50 for each of the 100 graffiti locations and also possible cleanup fees. Officials say each graffiti block will take up to an hour to remove using a high-pressure solution of baking soda and water.
Democrats assess President Bush's first 100 days and find out the healthiest way to slim down just in time for summer. Stay with us.
Pretty trashy circle, the circle that helps this circle.
It starts when we recycle trash at home. It's completed when we buy products made from recycled materials. Check the label for something called post-consumer recycled content. Then buy the highest percentage of it you can find. Complete the circle.
Call 1-800-CALL-EDF for your free buy recycled shopping guide. 1-800-CALL-EDF.
It is a test, not just of strength, but of the power of the mind. And if you complete the journey, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
A crowd of supporters greeted President George W. Bush as he arrived in Arkansas yesterday. Bush will headline an event in Little Rock for Senator Tim Hutchinson. As the top GOP fundraiser, Bush is expected to help pull in an estimated $700,000 for the senator's reelection campaign. Hutchinson could be in for a tough reelection fight next year against Attorney General Mark Pryor. Earlier, the president was in New Orleans, where he promoted his tax cut and budget plans. From Arkansas, Bush will head to Texas to attend a reading event with his mother in Houston.
Democrats offered an assessment today of President Bush's first 100 days in office. The gathering of lawmakers from both houses of Congress was held on the grounds of the Capitol building and was led by Richard Gephardt, the House Minority Leader, and Tom Daschle, the Minority Leader in the Senate. They criticized the new administration for its stance on tax cuts, protection of the environment, and workplace safety. Gephardt said that despite promises on the campaign trail, President Bush had failed to make good on creating a bipartisan spirit in the new Congress. Yesterday, in an interview with CNN, Bush had summarized his tenure to date as pretty darn good. The White House will host an event on Monday to highlight what it considers to be his achievements.
Japan's lower house of parliament has just confirmed Junichiro Koizumi as the next prime minister. He received more than 240 votes needed in a parliament dominated by his ruling party and its coalition partners. Koizumi takes office today after being sworn in by the emperor. Once described as an eccentric, he assumes the government's top post, promising to reform the stagnant economy.
This afternoon in the quad, there were several activities for students to participate in to help blow off some steam before finals. The Student Association of Campus Activities sponsored boxing in an inflatable ring, jousting, and a bungee run. SACA event coordinator Jibri Jones says the SACA-sponsored event is supposed to help students relax and release stress before finals. The Army Reserve's recruiters were also on hand and attracted many students with a climbing wall.
Smokers may want to add a few extra glasses of fruit juice to their diet. According to new federal guidelines, smokers need more vitamin C than non-smokers to help wash out the extra toxins in the body. Experts say antioxidants like vitamin C can help counteract the harmful effects of tobacco and nicotine. New recommended daily allowances of vitamin C for non-smokers have increased from 70 to 90 milligrams a day.
Today, it seems that every time you turn on the television, listen to the radio, or make a simple trip to the store, you're bombarded by ads trying to get you to shed those unwanted love handles. News 23's Tanya Kasner takes a deeper look into weight loss and tells you what those diet products don't.
Getting in shape is something that we all think about from time to time. Dietary supplements and weight loss fads are becoming the popular way to lose pounds. But do they really work? Dr. Friedman, chairperson of the Department of Family and Consumer Sciences and registered dietitian, says with any weight loss program, you might lose some initial water weight, but people get bored of the diet quickly, they quit, and ultimately gain all the weight back. She says those interested in getting healthy and losing weight need to pay more attention to what's reality instead of what's the miracle they're looking for. Most people get hooked by promises of quick weight loss with products that don't and can't give those results.
There's really nothing we can do about it except to educate people and to, you know, help them realize that there are no quick fixes. You didn't gain 10 pounds overnight. You're not going to lose 10 pounds overnight. I'll tell you what, if I could find a way to do it, I'd do it too.
By taking dietary supplements, you're also taking a major health risk. Just recently, the popular miracle diet pill FinFin was removed from the market when studies showed it was causing defects of the heart valves. Other popular diet pills now contain an ingredient called L-phenylalanine, which carries with it a possible risk of malignant melanoma skin cancer. This is no small matter to sun-loving health enthusiasts who make up an important segment of consumers of such products.
Dietary products can be found pretty much anywhere nowadays. Dietary supplements such as Metabolife have an ingredient inside called ephedrine, which has been linked to heart attacks and heart disease. The best regimen to stay in shape, a healthy diet, and strict exercise.
Exercising plays a key role in losing weight and getting healthy. In this day and age, some people would rather pop a pill that promises to build muscle than spend 3 to 4 hours a week at the gym and get guaranteed results. Jennifer Brown, Assistant Director of Campus Recreation and Fitness, says getting in shape can be one of the hardest things to discipline yourself to do.
You can't just work out. You can just work out, but it'll take you a lot longer to see the benefits of working out if your goal is like to lose weight, which is most people's is. If you put, you know, working out plus nutrition, you're gonna see results a lot quicker and you're gonna see them last.
Those interested in starting a healthy lifestyle can call Dr. Friedman at 245-2155. She can refer you to a nutritional expert here on campus that can help you. You can also call the Student Rec Center at 245-2940, and they can give you information on aerobics and yoga programs, as well as set you up with a personal trainer. An informative website to look at for further health information is the Weight Control Information Network at www.nih.gov. The best way to get in shape, though, is to start a program today. Don't wait for a reason, because the only reason should be you.
In the few months right before summer is when everyone puts their running shoes on and shows up to the gym. What's the skinny on the popularity? Well, we all want to fit into that favorite bathing suit right before summer. The truth on staying healthy, though, is you must exercise 3 to 4 times a week all year long. That way, you'll maintain a healthy body, a healthy mind, and overall a healthy lifestyle. Reporting from West Campus, I'm Tanya Kastner, News 23.
Spring is finally here, but the air is filled with mold. The recent moist, low-pressure air mass brought with it as much as 2 inches of rain. When the drier high-pressure system moved in, it brought sun and warmer weather. Lots of rain, followed by lots of sun, has driven the molds of Central Texas into a growing frenzy. Molds are at almost 3,600 grains per million, and flowering grasses at 115 grains. Pecan and oak are almost through their growing cycles, with less than 30 grains per million each. So, dust the yellow stuff off your car, the oak season is almost over. But don't forget to clear out moist, dark places in your house to avoid aggravating mold allergies.
Well, it's sure to be a beautiful day is outside. Will this warm weather last through the weekend? Ben Gibbs is up next with the weather.
Terrell Bishop is angry and taking to the street again tonight to take it back from pushers and gangs and make it safe for his four-year-old.
We go out there and patrol the streets and talk to the youngsters.
Terrell is a mad dad. Family men who work with local authorities to keep their neighborhoods safe.
We try to get them away from the gang life because a lot of us that's part of Mad Dads are ex-gang members.
It's time for the men to stand up and be men and take their part and do what is needed so our young kids can grow up in a safe environment.
Just making a lot of people feel a lot safer by us being out there, walking around.
Every child should have a man in their life, a positive man in their life.
Not everyone has to take to the streets, but everyone can take a step to help kids. Call us. We're fighting for the children. Whose side are you on?
Because you believed in me,
I can believe in you.
I can believe in me.
Because you pushed me to be
because
better.
Because you pushed me to be better.
I learned to push myself.
Push myself.
Because you showed me respect.
Respect.
I respect others. I respect myself.
Because you showed me a place.
I can use everything you
taught me.
I found my place.
I have found my place.
This is my place.
For all the young men and women in the United States Air Force, there was one person who showed them the possibilities and opened the door. To the teachers, counselors, ministers, and moms and dads who helped a young man or young woman discover that the greatest force of all is inside of themselves. We thank you. And more importantly,
thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
They thank you.
Currently in San Marcos at 78 degrees with a 32% humidity. It's a beautiful sunny day outside. Looking at temperatures across Texas, we have temperatures in the high 70s over here toward the east side of Texas, 79 in Dallas and Austin, 77 in Houston and Brownsville, 78 up in Amarillo, with a 74 right here in El Paso. Looking at temperatures around the country, we've got a lovely 80-degree system sitting in the middle of the country as a high-pressure system is sitting here, warm, dry air. There's a little bit of warmer, actually cooler, moisture air blowing south toward Mexico. And we actually hit 100 degrees in California, 90 degrees up toward the north. It actually gets really cold as the jet stream blows more cold air up around here toward the east side of the country. Looking at the national weather, we have nice dry weather here. And it's going to stick around for probably a week, maybe more. A couple of showers down toward the south, but they're moving down around us. And other moist weather is moving around us to the north. There's some rain out off the coast, which isn't going to affect us at all. And there's actually a little bit of rain down here in South Florida, which is, again, moving out toward the coast. It breaks their drought they've had for arguably months or years, depending how you look at their rainfall. But point is, it looks beautiful, dry, and warm here. Moving ahead to the three-day forecast. Tonight's low is 54 degrees. We expect a high tomorrow of 80 degrees and then up to 84 on Saturday. It looks like it's going to be sunny into the weekend and probably most of the way into next week, with a couple more clouds toward the middle of the week, possibly rain toward next weekend. Awesome. Great weekend weather. Loving it.
Absolutely.
Loving it.
Good weekend to get outside and try to relax before finals start.
Maybe I can finally wash my car and get all the yellow dust off.
Sounds like a good
okay.
idea.
Great. Next, we'll tell you what's in store for the SWT track team, and we'll see if Pudge kept his 10-game hitting streak alive against the Blue Jays. Tony Oram has the highlights. Stay with us.
Someone once said, we all come into this world alone, and we leave the same way. But in between, we have the chance to connect and help each other, to find ways you can do something to connect with the people in your community. Call the Points of Light Foundation. Do something good. Feel something real.
They've given our generation a label. X. Generation Nothing. They say we have no sense of purpose. They say we have no war to fight and no cause to believe in. Who are they? Join the thousands of us who are making a difference and wear a label that does mean something.
My son, Daku, was riding a motorcycle when he was struck by a car. I had spoken to him previously about donating his organs, and it made it so much easier for me to make the decision. I knew that this is something that he wanted. I didn't have to feel guilty about making the decision, doing something that he may not have wanted. Every day I tell people, talk it over. You must let people know what you want.
SWT's track and field team is just 3 weeks away from the Southland Conference Championship track meet. Both men and women fired out the starting blocks well this year, with long jumper Brian Veal already qualifying for the NCAA Track and Field Championships. This weekend, the track team will be in Des Moines, Iowa, competing in the Drake Relays. The team is a favorite for the SLC Championships because the men are returning champions and the women won the SLC Indoor Championships in February. Now off to the World Cup, where the U.S. tried to improve on a 3-0 record in the final round. Early on, Josh Wolf controls the ball in the box and beats goalie Eric Lonis. But Ronaldo Parks makes a great save with the bicycle move. Take another look. Parks showing Americans how it's done with the great save in the 70th minute. Clint Mathis off the corner kick sets up Josh Wolf for the goal. It's 1-0 USA. Check the replay. Mathis seems to get his hand on the ball, but it's a no call. The United States win on a controversial goal, leaving the Americans with a cushion atop of the standings. This week, NASCAR makes its way to California for the NAPA 500, and included in the field is Shauna Robinson, who will try to become the first woman to run a Rinsen Cup event since 1989. Robinson says she hopes young girls can learn from her example. Robinson also says drivers shouldn't be judged by their sex or size. Robinson finished sixth in the ARCO points last year, but this season she's hoping to run six Rinsen Cup events beginning this weekend. The Braves entered Wednesday's matchup with the Astros 5 games out of first place. It was the furthest they have been since trailing the Philadelphia Phillies by 5 games in the 95 season. The Astros were hoping to take advantage at Enron Field. Bottom of the third, Andrew Jones takes Scott Arlington's gift to the right field. 4-0 Braves. Jeff Bagwell, bottom of the sixth, trying to stay close when he takes Kevin Miller's pitch off the wall for a home run. 4-3 Braves at the top of the seventh. Astros playing good defense. Brian Jordan lines it to Craig Biggio with a great catch. Jordan, he's just in disbelief. 6-3 Braves, eighth inning, when Chipper Jones, like three pitches, especially that one, he takes it deep to deep right field, and that's the game. He puts it out of reach. Braves win 11-3. Reliever Jeff Zimmerman received the Tip O'Neill Award as Canada's Outstanding Major League Player for the 1999 season in a pregame ceremony. Zimmerman, who made the All-Star team with a 9-3 record, was The Rangers came to town trying to spoil the festivities. Bottom of the first, Toronto up one when Brad Fulmer takes Kenny Rogers to deep right. It's his second blast of the season. 4-0 Jays. Top of the sixth, Andre Scalarraga, the big cat, with the big bomb, the deep center off Chris Carpenter. It's his fifth of the season. 5-4 Rangers at the bottom of the frame. Jose Cruz Jr. comes to the plate, and he would get the blooper, the fall to shallow center. Carlos Delgado comes home. Cruz matches his longest hit streak of his career at 18 games. We're tied up at 5 at the bottom of the eighth when Fulmer back up at plate. It would ground one to Alex Rodriguez, who can't get Fulmer at first. Raul Mondesi comes home to score. Toronto adds 2 more to beat the Rangers, 8-5. Ivan Rodriguez extends his hit streak to 11 games, while A-Rod's 12-game hit streak is snapped.
All right. Well, hey, I guess the Spurs have got the Timberwolves here on Saturday going into Game 3 of their series, huh?
Yeah, the Timberwolves say they're not going to lay down and that they're very optimistic. But unfortunately, not too many teams have come back from a 2-0 deficit. Mm-hmm. Especially against a team like the San Antonio Spurs. So it should be pretty interesting this weekend.
All right, good deal.
Thanks, Tony.
A Honda Little League coach is facing disorderly conduct charges after he showed his backside to coax smiles from his players on picture day. Coach Bob Ross says he was just trying to get his team to smile for the camera when the incident occurred. Ross says he lifted his shirt to show his large barrel chest, and then he asked the team if they wanted to see his better half. One parent says Ross exposed about half of his buttocks. The parent was offended and filed charges against the coach. However, Ross says he dropped his shorts maybe 2 inches at most. Ross faces a misdemeanor that carries a $200 fine.
Thank you for watching the last broadcast of News 23 this semester. Be sure to tune in next fall on Wednesdays and Thursdays at 4:30. Good luck on finals, and congratulations to the graduating seniors. Yes, it would.
All right. Both y'all are leaving me, aren't you?